So let's take a look at this 0.9991 R2 accuracy value and think about why it is so accurate. So our model seems like it's amazing. So why has that happened? This is important that you understand how the R2 value is actually worked out and what do they actually show you. An important thing to first be aware of is we have said that this is based on test set. So this is important, test set. So what does that actually mean? What are accuracy based on test set? So not just on any data set, on test set. This is because when we started to build our model, we said this is our full data set. So these are the house sizes and these are the prices. Then we split them into X and Y. And then we said we would split our data using this built-in function into this module. We will use that to split our data up to 20%. 20% of the data will be used for testing. And we said that these are the two values. So house size, the price of 2,500 square feet versus 800 square feet and the house prices that we have. So this is the test data. So out of this one, so as you can see, 2,500 exists within the data set and that has been selected for testing. And the other one that's been used is 800, or 800 exists within our data over here. And you can see that that's a house price there. So the important part is when we look at this R2, it's based on test set. So it's just basically based on those two records. So let's demonstrate this on the graph. So those two points. So here you can see the test data is in green. So we know there was a value around 800 square feet. So that's that one. So this is the size over here. So we're going size and we're going price over here. And you can see the other value that we had was 2,500 and that's where it is. So the model has basically predicted this line of best fit. Okay. So, and the blue ones are the training data. And why did we get, so the question becomes, why did we get 0.9991 accuracy? That's 3.9 accuracy. Why is it so accurate? So if you look at the graph, you can see one of the points is actually pretty bang on. It's right on the line. The other one is slightly off over there. So based on that, it works out this R2 value. And you can see some of the data points, more the one we use for training, some are off. So in some instances, the value here is, if you were to predict it on this value, so which is, you know, if you go that from here, you can see that it would predict a price of around this value, which would be maybe 320, but the actual one is a bit higher. But on some situations, it's actually pretty good. It's right on the line, but you can see there are some which are under, there are some which are points which are over that line. And you can see with the R2 values in the green that these are actually, one of them is on the line and one of them is just under the line. So that's why you get this accuracy figure here. Remember, this is a very small data set. If you were to amplify this over a large data set, you would get similar outputs. So of course, it would be much harder to show you in the example. So that's why we have a small data set to demonstrate all this. So let's continue to look at these aspects more in detail in the next explanation.